Ladies and gentlemen, thanks for being part of this evening broadcast, Timeless Wisdom. It is my prayer that God of heaven will also meet you at the point of your need. He will put bread on your table. He will put bread on your table. He will put clothes upon your back. He will put shoes upon your foot. He will put roof over your head. The Lord will increase you. He will enlarge you. The Lord will wipe away your tears. Guess what? You don't have to put up with mediocrity. You don't have to put up with the onslaught of the devil, because you are on the winning side, because you are a child of God. You should be at peace. The devil has no right to torment your children with drugs. Your children should not be on drugs. And if they are today, we pray and we declare deliverance, that they are totally delivered from the demons of cocaine, demons of drugs, in Jesus' name. If you are unemployed, it is not the will of God for you not to have a job. The Bible says, he that does not work must not eat. So it is not the will of God for you to be idle. And so today, I declare open heavens and open doors that we give you the opportunity to be able to get the job that you need to get. I declare open heavens over your family, over your home, over your destiny, that you no longer be stranded, you no longer be on the same spot. Today, you'll be able to move forward and fulfill your destiny in Jesus' mighty name. I want to challenge you this evening. I began a series of messages 3 weeks ago, which I titled Covenant Rights. And the Lord is giving me unction to be able to talk about it again today. But I want to submit to you today that the Bible says in the book of Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 5, I think verse 5, the Bible says that, you and myself should not rely on harm of flesh, because the flesh will always disappoint. So verse 7 says, blessed is the man that hope in the Lord, and whose hope the Lord is. Verse 8 says, for it shall be like a tree that is planted. It shall be like a tree that is planted by the waters. The Bible says that you will flourish. The Bible says in the book of Psalm 92, verse 13, the Bible says they flourish that are planted in the court of our God. So you need to be planted. You cannot be moving from one church to another church, to another church, to another church. You need to be planted. You cannot be moving, being a Christian today, you become another believer in another religion tomorrow. Moving from one herbalist to another herbalist, you need to be focused. And you also need to know that on this planet Earth, you have the privilege to make a quality decision as per what your eternity will be. And if you are not a Christian, if you are not born again, I'm not talking about religious nonsense. If you are not born again, there's no hope for you to make heaven. There's no hope for you to be reconciled with God. The only avenue for us to be born again and to be reconciled with God is through the blood of Jesus Christ. Without the blood of Jesus Christ, there is no hope for man. That's why Jesus came and he died on the cross. He rose again the third day. So Jesus Christ is alive. We're celebrating the fact that Jesus is alive. So when Jesus came, he did not bring religion. He brought life. The life that we lost in the Garden of Eden, He restored back to us. And so I challenge you this evening to know your covenant right and to walk in the same. So the Bible says, blessed is the man that trusted in the Lord and whose hope the Lord is. So I'm telling you this evening, where do you place your hope? Where do you place your hope? Where do you place your hope? Our hope is in the Lord. For it shall be like a tree that is planted. The Bible says, we not see when drought shall come. And he will not be careful in the year of drought. On the year of drought, he will not be careful. In other words, when there's economic crunch, when there is economic depression, when there is a problem, when there's unemployment, when, you know, there is economic upheavals, the Bible said that you will not be careful in the year of drought, in the year of famine. You know, you will not be rationing food. You will not, you know, have 010 or 010. That's not the will of God. The will of God is for you to eat and eat and be full, so that there is perpetually food on your table. So that there is perpetually food on your table. Every need is met. When you need to spend money, money shows up. When you need to buy new clothes, to change the wardrobe, there is money to do that. That's the will of God. It's not the will of God for you to struggle and to go from hand to mouth. That's a survivor mode. God wants you to live well. So we began to look at it, and then we saw the fact that if anybody is going to complain, it's only Jesus that has the right to complain. But you do not have the right to complain, because Jesus Christ, who was rich in eternity, he came to time and he became poor. In the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 8 verse 9, he became poor so that you will no longer be poor. He was manhandled, he was ridiculed so that you no longer be ridiculed. He became a public ridicule so that you will no longer be ridiculed. So Jesus Christ played the part, and we emphasize the fact that, you know, when you are faced with circumstances of life, you must learn to dig in rather than up and go. You must be ready to dig in. You don't quit your matrimonial home because you're having challenges in your marriage. You don't quit. You don't quit. You don't quit. Don't quit your home. Don't quit your destiny. Don't abandon your children. Don't abandon your wife. Don't abandon your husband because of the challenges you are facing. It does not matter, because it's only a phase. It will change. Things will change again. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, because you are with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. In the midst of that thing, guess what? It's only a shadow. That trouble you are facing is only a shadow. It's only a shadow. It looks like a lion, but it's not a lion. It's only a lion. It looks like a lion. It's not a lion. Amen. You must understand that. The Bible says in the book of First Peter chapter 5 verse 7, the Bible says, casting all your cares upon the Lord, because he cared for you. Why are you carrying the burden? When you have the anointing that will remove the burden, the anointing that will destroy the yokes, why are you carrying the burden yourself? Let it go. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go. Casting all your burdens upon the Lord. Burdens that emanate from matrimonial troubles, burdens that emanate due to immigration troubles, burdens that emanate due to sicknesses or diseases in your body, burdens that emanate due to work, your colleagues at work, you know, troubles that came maybe through the church, whatsoever may be the trouble, please do not quit. You must learn to dig in. You dig in, you become unmovable. You become steadfast in your faith. Become steadfast in your confessions. Become steadfast in your confessions. That this won't surpass. That you will, that you are coming back. You are not giving up. The righteous fall 7 times, but each time he's back on his feet. I pray that you'll be back on your feet. I know that you've been declared bankrupt, and it appears that all hope is lost. But go and check the history of the peeps, of some of the billionaires we have around. In one time or the other, they were declared bankrupt, but they became restored. They became restored because they did not give up. So I challenge you today, don't give up. I know you've been declared bankrupt, but don't give up. That's not the end of the world. Don't commit suicide because of the pressure at work, because of the stress at work. You want to give up, don't give up. You want to kill yourself, don't kill yourself. You are not mandated to kill yourself. You are not anointed to kill yourself. You have no right to take your own life because you don't give yourself the life. God gave you the life. Don't quit on God. So you must dig in. You must dig in. You must be unmovable. You must be steadfast. You must be steadfast. So when you become steadfast, you become unstoppable. So you have to place your dreams above your fears. Don't be afraid. Oh, it's gonna be well. It's gonna be well. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid of the circumstances of life. The Bible says in the book of Psalms 34 verse 19, many are the afflictions, many are the troubles of the righteous, many are the unpalatable circumstances of the righteous, many are the disappointments of the righteous. He said, but God deliver him out of them all. So God is a deliverer. Jesus is a deliverer. That's why he died, so that you can be totally delivered. You can be totally delivered. Why are you worried? Joel chapter 2 verse 32. It says, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be delivered. For in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem there is deliverance. I'll see you after the break.
Hello, I'm here with my mother. Came here to Wisdom House today. And I really like the people here. And they sort of really let you in. And they're really friendly, so that was nice to see. It shows you how to love people and their importance in society and how much they mean to you. So, and I'd like to give a big thank you to Pastor Steve and Pastor Honor.
Looking for a good place to worship? Do you desire to hear the undiluted Word of God? Would you like to be part of our big vibrant family? Then, Wisdom House International is the experience you need. Join us every Sunday from 10:30 a.m. for uplifting praise and worship and life-changing messages from our man of God, Pastor Steve. Join us at number 168, High Road, Chadwell Heath, Essex, RM6, 6LU, telephone 020-8597-3990.
Welcome back to this broadcast. We're looking at your covenant right. That you have to place your dreams above your fear. There's nothing to fear. If you need to start a business, go ahead. But you need to get your business plan, your feasibility study in place. It's so important that you get information. He that is not informed is deformed. He that is informed is empowered. It's so important that you don't work and conduct your life based on trial and error. Don't conduct your life like the one that beat the hair. It's so important, ladies and gentlemen, that you get it right. So do not quit on God. Place your dreams above your fears. Every day, whatever those nitty-gritty, those things that you do on a daily basis, they are writing your destiny. They are putting your destiny in place. You can achieve all your dreams, if you have enough courage to pursue them. If you don't use your courage, you will lose it. If you don't use your determination, it will desert you. If you don't use your power of decisions, you will lose it in no time. And those are the things that you need to understand. If you step out of the will of God, you step into nowhere. Every time you step out of the will of God, you step into nowhere. It's so important for you to know that without God factor, you are not made. Without God factor, you are less than zero. Without God factor, you can't go too far. You can't go too far. Without God factor, you cannot succeed. You may have success, but it's not going to be a good success. There's a major difference between success and a good success. So God warned Joshua, it is not enough to start the race, you must complete the race. And Joshua was able to successfully complete the race. He completed the race. He said, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. He completed the race, just like Apostle Paul completed the race. So I challenge you today for you to complete your race. Don't step out of the will of God, because every time you step out of the will of God, you step into nowhere. You step into nowhere. And every time you keep or pull back from a God-given opportunity, you lay another brick in the wall that prevents you from reaching your potentials, from maximizing your potentials. Every time you pull back from a God-given opportunity, there is a problem. There is a problem. So I challenge you today, don't pull back from a God-given opportunity. He has said before you an open door that no man can shut. God gave David opportunity to showcase his glory through him by bringing down Goliath. Goliath has already been defeated. Goliath has already been defeated, because you must not focus on the Goliath. Focus on the big God. Focus on the God of David. Focus on the bigness of God that is greater, mightier, and bigger, fatter than that Goliath. You just need to trust God just one more time. He's a faithful God. That business can blossom if you trust God enough. That your wife can be pregnant and give birth to a bouncing baby boy. I speak forth right now. You're watching me and you are trusting God for the fruit of the womb. I speak it forth right now in Jesus' name. As a matter of fact, you are trusting God for a bouncing baby boy. I declare today as a prophet of God that the heavens delivers your baby to you tonight in Jesus' name. Ensure that you have sexual intercourse with your husband today. And today you're going to be pregnant. In 1 month's time, 4 weeks' time, you go to your doctor. It will have been done. And when it happens, please let us know. God is a faithful God. Do not step back. Do not pull back from a God-given opportunity. When you do, there is trouble. So what do we do therefore to be able to key into our covenant rights? Number one, do not be tentative. Do not be casual. Do not be tentative at all. You must know what you want and pursue it. You must know what you want and go after it. Don't be casual in your faith. Don't be tentative in your faith. You must pursue what is God-given mandate for your life. You must pursue the mission for which you have been commissioned. It is so important that you don't quit on God. Don't be casual. Don't be tentative. It's so important. Number two, do not be ignorant of the devices of the devil. Do not undermine the ability of the devil. You just need to pay a visit to hospitals to see how the devil has been devastating people. You need to pay a visit to psychiatric hospitals to see how devil has been destroying lives. So it is true, devil is real. Devil is real. The kingdom of darkness is real. The kingdom of the devil is real. Do not be ignorant of the devices of the devil. It's so important for you to know. But one thing you must know is that the Jesus says in the book of Luke chapter 10 verse 19, he said, behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions, and over every power or over every ability of the devil. So it's so important for you to know that devil is not the champion, you are the champion. But do not ignore the fact that there is the kingdom of darkness. And that's the truth. There is a kingdom of darkness. Number three, do not be deceived by devil's trying to say God is wicked. No, do not buy that. Don't allow the devil to misinform you. God is not a wicked God. God is not a bad God. He is a good God. 24/7, God is good. 24/7, God is excellent. 24/7, He is mighty. 24/7, He is a wonderful God. He's a splendid God. He's a mighty God. James 1:17. Every good gift, every perfect gift is from the above, from the Father of lights, in whom there is no variableness, no shadow of turning. Don't let the devil misinform you that God is not good. God is good. Number four, you must resist the devil. Resist the devil, the Bible says, and the devil shall flee. Resist the devil. Tell the devil to take his hands off your finances. Tell the devil to take his hands off your children. They must not be wayward. They must not be wild. They must not become terrorists. They must not become instruments in the hands of the devil. Tell the devil where the devil belongs, under your foot. Resist the devil and the devil shall flee. You must not have round table discussion or conference with the devil. What is the devil doing? Why is the devil having the lunch in your house? Why is the devil having breakfast in your house? Why is the devil joining you to have dinner, to have the supper in your house? Why are you entertaining the devil? Because you have the instrument of the devil in your house. You have idols in your life that keep inviting the devil into your house. Your television has become your idol. Your beauty has become your idol. Your car has become your idol. Your money has become your idol. You know it. These things have become your idol. You prefer, you give attention to them than you give to God. You know how many hours you use to polish your car? You know how many hours you spend with your computer, with your laptop? You know, these things are idols. They're, you know, robbing you of fellowship with God. And that is giving the devil opportunity to keep coming back to your house. You may not have juju, you may not have voodoo in your house as in court, but there are idols in your life, you know, that limiting the presence of God in your life. And you need to change. You spend 4 hours, 3 hours in front of a mirror. Why? And you spend only 5 minutes having communion with God. As a matter of fact, you have turned into monologue. It's no longer a dialogue. When you pray, you talk to God. You don't wait to hear from God. You are too much in a hurry. Your job has become your idol. There's no more time for God. I challenge you today to change. The Bible says, resist the devil and the devil shall flee. How do we resist the devil? Number one, through the word of God. Through the word of God. You resist the devil through the word of God. You must know the word. You are no longer a baby. You've been born again for how many years? And yet you don't know the word of God. He that despised the word, Proverbs 13:13, shall be destroyed. In verse 15, the Bible says, good understanding giveth favor. He said, but the way of the transgressor is hard. Why is your way hard? Why is your life hard? Because you don't have time for the word of God. For you to receive the devil, it's not by, you know, pouring out water from the bottle. It's not by using an anointing horn. No, you must know the word. You must chew the word. God told Joshua, oh, if you want to succeed on this journey, you must know the word. This book of the law must not depart out of your mouth. Not physics, not chemistry, not economics, not project management. We're talking about the word of God. The word of God. The word of God, Psalm 119 verse 89. It says, forever, oh God, that word is settled in heaven. The word of God is settled in heaven. Psalm 119 verse 74. He said, the word is better for me than silver than gold. The word of God is better for me than silver than gold. Number one, the word of God. The word of God. The word of God. Number two, the name of Jesus. You receive the devil through the name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. The Bible says in the book of Philippians chapter 2, verse 9, that for God has given him a name that's above every other name, that the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus is Lord. So I challenge you today. Number three, obedience. Isaiah chapter 1 verse 19 says that if you are willing and obedient, you will heed the good of the land. Time will not permit me to complete, but I just want to challenge you. Get connected and hooked.
Welcome to Wisdom House International, where you will be inspired and empowered to be your best in Christ as we are rooted in the infallible Word of God. Wisdom House is a contemporary army of winners. At Wisdom House, we believe passionately that God has created an amazing destiny for everyone and that He is committed to helping people live abundant lives, dream big, and achieve their highest calling. We would like to invite you to worship with us at any of our branches worldwide. You can access our website 24/7. We are committed to working in partnership with you to make your Christian walk a success. We encourage you to worship with us under the Holy Spirit inspired atmosphere. Your picture in the scripture determines your future. We are located at Wisdom House, premises, ground floor, 168 High Street, Chadwell Heath, Essex, RM6, 6LU. God bless you.